Rocky, it was a start for you guys where you only had 4 shots on goal for the first 20 minutes. You knew that wasn't your group, so what'd you do in the second and third to twist that narrative around?
You know what? I actually thought we were playing pretty good in the first 5 or 6 minutes. We just weren't generating a whole lot, and I do think we had Kostas had a shot. I don't know who's tallying those shots for us, but I thought they missed one. but, you know, obviously... that first period's not what we're hoping to accomplish as a group. We came in and we talked about what we needed to do to get some offensive zone possession. We weren't placing pucks on entry very well. We were putting them below the goal line and inside the dots, and they're sagging their middle D and giving them a lot of time to go retrieve those pucks. So we talked about where that puck needed to be. Obviously, they play their third really high, their third forward, and they have 3 across every time you're trying to enter their blue line. So we looked for a couple different options for us to get possession of pucks, but part of that was strictly hard work and our willingness to touch it first. And we started to do that more in the second period. Ironically, I thought we were the better team for about 15 of the 20 minutes in the second period, yet we're still down 2-0 going into the third. So the message in the third was just maintain what we do. Stick to our resolve. There's no panic here. We have a lot of confidence. We've got some swagger. Let's go out and find a way to win a game.
And then you guys eventually did do that, but it starts in the third period where you have a penalty to kill you, allowed a power play goal in period 2, but it's Lucas Wallin after a pass from Thompson, a 2-on-1 rush. Wallin selling shot the whole way, blisters it past Jack Williams, and now you have some momentum.
We did, and you know what, obviously, you know, we don't love the penalty there at the end of the second, but I know where Gleb's going there. He's trying to generate some energy for our group, and you know, he brings that to us. I thought he played really good tonight. Their line was really good. Obviously, Grimesy had 2, but they were physical. They were hard on pucks. Gleb had a couple really big hits to kind of turn the tide. And so that's going to happen sometimes. A guy that plays that way is going to get a penalty from now and again. And Daltz had a pretty inspiring speech for his teammates at the end of the second period. And then you know, we came out and really played Stars hockey in the third.
And Doug Grimes was the guy to tie it, his first goal with the Lincoln Stars. Then he adds another one to tie up the game again. What does number 19 bring to your team?
Man, he's such a old-school hockey player, right? He's hard. He's heavy. He plays with a lot of passion and emotion. He understands the type of player that he is, and he embraces that really, really well. And he was the perfect fit for our group. That trade was a steal for us, and he's been a great addition. That adds a really big guy that's obviously got a lot of talent. He's got now 4 or 5 points, I think, since he's been here as a Star. So really, really proud of Grimesy and just the way that he's been able to impact us in a positive way.
And a way that you guys have wanted to generate offense is right around the net front. You got away from that in the first period. And in the third period, all the goals, for the most part, they're second chance opportunities, hard plays. Usato, after the pickoff by Marcellus in the D zone, makes it 5-4. This place explodes. They're up for grabs. So what were you impressed with the most about that play?
You know what? Sato was feeling it. And I thought he played really, really good hockey this evening. And I thought he played good last Saturday, too. He had gotten away from his game a little bit since Christmas time, and he knew that. And he came in and talked to us about what he needed to do to get back to being the impactful player that he's capable of. And I thought he really, really showed that tonight. And so, you know, I had a feeling that he was going to get his opportunity. Sometimes you get lucky as a coach. And I put Raf down and I put Sato up for that shift, and he made me look like a pretty smart guy in that one.
And Cameron Whitehead, we don't talk about a lot of blemishes that he's had in his young USHL career, but he allows that third goal to Jake Schneider. He dials it back in the 5-4 game, makes a couple of big saves. Big win for 39, but an example of you picking up your goaltender that has stood on his head all season long.
Oh, man. Like, hey, Whitey is entitled to a couple soft ones, but he's set the bar so high that when one goes in that you don't expect to go in, you're kind of looking like, did that just really happen? But he's a young goalie, and nobody's perfect. The other 20 guys on the ice make mistakes all the time. And we don't notice them as casual fans. When a goaltender makes a mistake, the red light goes on and everybody stands up. And so you have to understand that they're kids and they're vulnerable. They're not going to be perfect. And so for him to bounce back after that and show us what he's really made of, is that's a true tell sign of what your character is. And Whitey did a great job of holding us in there at the end.
It's your first win when trailing after 2 periods this season. Another comeback victory in an effort at the icebox. Is the mantra for this team never say die?
I think that's the mentality you have to have as a group. It's not a 40-minute game. It's a 60-minute game. And you know, we talked, like I said, about just staying the course and believing in ourselves. It was two shots to tie it. It ended up having to be five shots to win it. Hey, it was a great crowd tonight. And I thought crossover night went great considering the things that we're dealing with here in society, and love the fact that we had these student athletes here and support for the university. So couldn't have given the fans a better effort, and obviously great way to finish it.
Rocky, congrats on the win. We'll see you tomorrow.
Thanks, Cristiano.